rolling. And then uncurling my arms. If you get lost, you can always come back to this. Feeding, reaching, pulling nourishment in. And you can experiment with other body parts, helping you come up and down. Like, if I use my leg here as a lever, it can help bring back some of the gravity. And this top arm can help. Also, if I keep this arm in, it's a little bit more heavier to negotiate down. It's possible, but a little bit more muscly. But if I use my other arm to come up, I can navigate that as well. You can try from one side to the other. So you can try coming down. My other arm, my top arm, is assisting me. Remember, we're doing a spiral pattern. So the little side of the hand is a feeler. How do I know where to put the hand down? So if I have my arms in my visual field, my hands in my visual field, rather than back here where I can't really have a strong connection with what I'm doing. And if I'm like driving from my empress, my heart, my hand just lands in this perfect place for it to be underneath my body, my torso, body, and then I can roll over to the other side. And now this arm becomes the lever arm, and I can pivot and push. You can play with different amounts of weight and spaciousness. Want another kind of cool key? Can I just watch a little bit as you guys, can you do it a little bit more? I want to just see what's missing. There's more space over here, if anyone's getting a little crowded, there's more space over there. The head, torso, pelvis staying in like a line. So sort of this kind of thing, still mostly on one plane. So I'm coming up and I'm like doing like a log roll. I'm pushing up again. See what I'm talking about? And a counsel would be to try to get about a little more 3D. So again, my arm is, if it comes out here, it's going to get me more into the log roll, kind of accordion action. And if I have my arm a little bit in front of me, I can roll but also tilt. So just maybe bring your arms out for a second and feel this motion of the arms driving the heart. And then feel how that shifts if the heart drives the arms. A little bit different quality. Okay, this is like the secret sauce. This is what I'm about to say. So as you're letting the arms drive, if you flex at the thoracic between T3 and T5, if you know where that is, your upper back flexion, it means bending forward, you'll be able to do a lot more, have a lot more motion around your heart because of the shape of the spinous processes. So flexion, and then can actually twist. So if there's flexion, you can do a side bend, right, on the lateral plane, but I can also twist. So you might notice if you don't flex, try twisting in your upper thoracic, meaning with your upper torso. because I have not a lot of room, but if you have a little flexion. So as you're going down, what helps me really get onto this fleshy bit here, so if, as I'm coming down, is that there's a little bit of flexion. Oh, like butter. So then I can turn towards the ground, which is my support, as I come up. Try that. Did you see that? Did you see it? So I can turn here. And then as I'm coming down, this is the part where the flexion really helps. Right on the way up. So you're aiming for this bit right here on your spine. Try a couple times going, rolling from side to side.